Michaela's mother and I brought Michaela into this world. We cradled her in our arms, loved and nurtured her through the years, and guided her to adulthood. Today, we gave her hand to Bryant to hold and caress. From this day forward, may Michaela and Bryant live their lives together forever in happiness and love in the embrace of our Lord.
Bestowed upon him who fears the Lord, be he rich or poor, his heart is content, and a smile is ever on his face.
He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, even as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother to be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.
Unsettling college can be in those early years. And so the Newman Center seeks to be a place of refuge, a place of security, a place of safety, where young people can come together and find friendship, precisely based on a friendship that they bring with them. And that's their friendship with Jesus. Both Michaela and Bryant are people who, from a young age, were nurtured in friendship with Jesus. I want their mom and dads to stand up, please. Leroy and Brenda, if you would, and Rob and Linda, please. Here's mom and dad. It's nice to look at them. Take a good look. Leroy and Brenda, 28 years of marriage, and Rob and Brenda, 25 years of marriage. Your love is beautiful, just as this cross is beautiful. And just as the cross has gotten more beautiful over the centuries, your marriage, your love is going to be more beautiful, right? Say, everybody, take a look at real close now at Michaela and Bryant. Real good looking, huh? They're handsome, aren't they? It's a beautiful couple. We all know something, though, don't we? If we're really honest, they won't always look that good, will they? This is what the cross Michaela and Brian will tell you and keep so close to you that your love is beautiful and it's generous. Because in this world, generosity is often difficult. It touches us and it causes us suffering and pain. But as we work through it, like the cross, like Jesus in the cross, we become people who are more and more beautiful. Like, for instance, your mom and dad, right? Who are more beautiful today, I bet. Go back to their wedding pictures, and I'll bet you'll see that they are more beautiful today than they were then. You're ready to enter into this beautiful life, this life of generosity that we invite you now to stand and to come. You have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community of friends and family. Christ abundantly blesses the love that you share. He has already consecrated you, made you his own in baptism. And now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Brian and Michaela, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I have.
Will you love and honor each other's husband? His wife for the rest of your life?
I will.
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I will.
I will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, turn towards each other, join your hands, and declare your consent before God and His church.
I, Bryant, take you, Michaela, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I'm Michaela, take you, Bryant, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. Will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, let no one divide. May the Lord bless these rings which you will give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
My soul belongs to you.
May the Lord Jesus Christ, who was a guest at the wedding in Cana, bless you and your families and friends. May Jesus, who loved his church to the end, always fill your hearts with his love. May he grant that as you believe in his resurrection, so you may wait for him in joy and hope. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
It's my privilege to introduce to you for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Bryant and Michaela Bryant.
I've known Bryant since kindergarten, the very first day of kindergarten. And I like to think we both looked at each other and we're like, yep, best friends right away. You know, Bryant, he's never one to come out and say something. You always got to ask him what's going on. Last time he's like, not much. Then one time he finally said, I got a girlfriend now. And I said, well, what's her name? And he said, it's Michaela. I'm like, well, why haven't I met Michaela? I said, I got an approval group before you can date her. So finally I met her and I was like, I think these guys are definitely made for each other. They fit so well together. Instant knew it was perfect.
Michaela and I have been close, very, very close. And she's been a very, very great role model for me. And I'd like to think we're sisters even before this happened. So when Bryant proposed, it was in Yellowstone, right? On Agate Creek, right? And this is how he did it. Do you guys know the story? Maybe some of you guys do. So they were searching for agates and really cool rocks, because it's something that Bryant really likes to do. And he was just like searching through the water, and Michaela had her back turned. Bryant gave her a rock first, right? So he so at first he gave her one, right? And he set up behind her and he said, Michaela, turn around, I have another rock for you. Is that verbatim or is that wrong?
That's verbatim.
That's good. And she turned around and, of course, he proposed. Michaela and I wrote a poem. And the poem is titled, Our Rock. Through memories of tears, through memories of laughter, through memories of days long sought after, you have always been there, right at our side, to be our rock and to be our guide. You are our family, you are our friends. You will be there for us till the very end. Both success and failure will you see us through, and we will always know who to turn to. We are so glad to see you on this special day. We now share together a new love and pray. God will watch and will be our guide, like you, the rock, always at our side.
Every father hopes his daughter will find a reliable, sensible, and considerate partner. You always hope your children will make the right choices in life, and Michaela and Bryant chose each other. Bryant is a special young man from a very special family. Michaela's mother and I brought Michaela into this world nearly 24 years ago. We cradled her in our arms, loved and nurtured her through the years, Today, we gave her hand to Bryant to hold and caress. From this day forward, may Michaela and Bryant live their lives together forever in happiness and love in the embrace of our Lord.
Fly away together, fly away. Let's hold hands, fly away, and skip to the beat of our hearts as they chatter, as it pitter, pitter, patter. Didn't you know that I could be your wingman flying around as we soar over the town? And I wouldn't mind if you and I would fly away together, fly away forever, honey. You and I could rule the sky, no need to think twice. We could leave behind our troubles if we flew around like lovers. Whenever we're ever two birds of a feather, the sun on our wings, let the adventures begin. And I wouldn't mind if you and I would fly away together, fly away forever, honey.